So what's happening is the science is unfolding at an exponential rate, and we're coming to that new bottle of the brain. And the thing that we're learning is how important the role of senses, feelings, and emotions are in thinking. And yet, well, what have we all been taught to do? Basically set aside at least the feeling and emotion part. We know we need our senses, like our eyesight senses, to at least take data in. But what we're finding is that basically the seat of consciousness itself, the ability even for your visual cortex to work, requires, believe it or not, emotion. Because emotion, or what we experience as emotion, its data form, if you will, its neurochemical flow in the brain, is actually kind of like the meaning tag on a blog. So if you're lacking, if there are people in the world who are lacking emotion, but their intellect, like they can do math really well, but they have no emotion whatsoever, they can't tell that that's a bottle of water, or that that's a table, or that's a chair, or that's, I believe, Dan Collins. they can't tell because the brain is lacking meaning information without that neurochemical signature.
Research on one side saying, you know, we make all these thinking mistakes and we use all these heuristics. And then there's all this research on the other side showing that this thinking, using feelings and emotions, and incorporating our bodies into the process and listening to what's going on in our bodies, that there is knowledge in there. And I think bringing that into the heuristics and biases literature is actually like, okay, we take a loss, and statistically, okay, we shouldn't let that loss affect us, right? I mean, statistically, theoretically, we shouldn't take the next loss. But is statistically the only thing that matters to us? On an evolutionary psychology basis, if you take a loss, is it reasonable to be more concerned about taking another loss? It's a perfectly reasonable thing to feel in terms of survival. It's a perfectly reasonable thing to feel in terms of evolution. So that feeling of fear, which has been shown in many cases to be valuable, like in directing our attention, we choose to ignore it, so we don't let it direct our attention. The issue is, and never having been taught to use that feeling of fear as any sort of valid data, we just act it out. The problem isn't the feeling. The problem is in the world of cognitive and behavioral psychology, thinking and behaving and leaving out the emotions, we just act the emotions out, as opposed to just feeling them and learning to analyze them the way the visual cortex is using them as data. And I submit that is something that we can all learn to do, unlearn what we have learned to do, that we can get better at it, and ultimately, if we can integrate it into risk management and put a psychological layer into the corporate risk management out there, we can actually avoid a lot.